Many people do not have wills, and I'm sure it's not the case with all of you, but just in case, we are here to talk to you about why you should have a will and what you have to think about when you make a will. A will is a document which you sign, which sets out your wishes upon your death, what happens in relation to your money, your assets, your estate, what happens in terms of whether you wish to be buried or cremated, what do you want to do, who do you want to look after, your children. So you can be very specific about how you want your affairs to be handled once you die. And this is a really great thing for the people that you leave behind, because it can eliminate family fighting, which happens very often when there isn't a will. And it reduces the stress on the people who you leave behind, who are most no doubt grieving. So it's very important to have a will from that respect. When you make a will, there are a number of factors which you have to consider and make decisions about. The first is, who do you want to be your executor of the will? The executor of the will is the person responsible for ensuring that your wishes that you've set out in your will are carried out. The executors should, if you have Bermuda property, we recommend that the executors be Bermudian, because that avoids costly and complicated immigration applications for licenses, and those licenses which are granted are for short periods of time. And we also recommend that you have at least two executors, one of whom is not a beneficiary of your will, so as to reduce the chance of fraud or dishonesty. And we've all seen articles in the press where cases have gone to court where executors have been dishonest and beneficiaries have lost out. Once the estate has been administered, if part of your estate is going to minor children, then the executors become trustees of the estate, which they must preserve for the benefit of the minor children until they become of age. So those are the important facts for thinking about an executor or a trustee of your will. Another point is, who are your beneficiaries going to be? Who do you want to leave your estate to? And another thing that you might want to consider is just leaving a fund of money that's available immediately to pay for things like funeral expenses or immediate expenses. It can take some time to have an estate administered, but if you leave a sum of money in a bank account held jointly with another person, that money automatically goes to the other person and they can access it and pay some of your immediate bills.